The point being that even with all the problems that I held on to the essential ingredient of wanting her to share our lives together, and I figured that whatever problems we had could be worked out if we wanted to go on with our lives. But apparently that's not what she wanted, because she bailed as soon as she could without putting much effort into trying to work things out. I mean, if she was only into it for herself instead of the both of us, then she would have put more effort into trying to work things out instead of escaping into a computer and trying to find someone else that was better for her. Like I told her about the bigger, better deal, and that she was trying to trade this life for another one on the Let's Make a Deal of Fate.
$1,000, right? Your daughter-in-law just missed a car a few seconds ago. You have a chance now to risk $1,000 and perhaps win a car. And here's why. The dealer wheel has just come out. You can spin it, risk your $1,000, and maybe end up with what's behind number one, curtain number one, and there is another automobile.
Mazda GLC Deluxe Sedan. Standard features include a peppy 1.5-liter engine, front-wheel drive, reclining front bucket seats, plus a roomy interior and more from Mazda. With tax and license, it retails for $8,550.
All right, now, the first Sobeck family member said, no, I'm going to not risk my $500 and miss the car. Let's see what happens when we go to a mother-in-law. Would you risk your $1,000 to spin this wheel? Now, take a look. Over here, it says car. There it says car. Triple your money, double your money, $4,000. And you can go down to $100 or $200.
My daughter-in-law says no.
Your daughter-in-law says no. You want to listen to her?
I think I better, don't you?
All right. You talked her out of it. Now, you know what that means? It means that the Sobecks are now going home with $1,500, right?
I showed my mom the Soulmates in Peril video that I made for her last wedding, the last wedding anniversary that we were together. And I got stuck telling her more of the technical parts of the video because I had trouble describing all the symbols in the story that I developed for Chris. That, you know, the symbols we had were had a lot of meaning for both of us. It certainly communicated some things, but what if they were not exactly the same things because of different levels of development? Maybe we interpreted the symbols differently due to different levels of development.
It's very sound. Now, what this means is all of the people working with these developmental models have come to a conclusion that there's the next stage that's about to emerge is something that many of them actually call integral and have been doing so for 30 or 40 years, you know, way before it sort of started to catch on. And they called it that because the data indicated that where all the previous stages tended to be at variance with each other. So that if you have a particular value structure that's traditional, then you disagree with modern values, you disagree with postmodern values, and you disagree with tribal values, and you think that only traditional fundamentalist values are right and everybody else is going to burn in hell. And so that tends to be the structure of so many of these stages. But when you get to integral, in any of these models, including Piaget, Piaget started adding a systemic integral stage of cognition. Gene Gebser, many of you know, sort of a pioneer, went from archaic to magic to mythic to rational to pluralistic to integral, or integral a perspectival. Jane Lovinger called her two highest stages autonomous and integrated. And the reason is at these integral or integrated stages, unlike all the previous stages, the integrated stage finds room for all of the previous values. It finds all of them to be important and starts incorporating them in a transparent, conscious way. So it's the first structure that...
I definitely meant the vow of always coming for her. And even if the distraction from the illusions of samsara, working out karma, would not delay me forever. Well, but what if Chris started to identify more with Belle in that video than Mayim Zadi, because she didn't think she could live up to the harder role symbolized by being Mayim Zadi, and gave in to her inner demons to fall back onto the role of Belle? In that way, she would be serving the red demons of her past conditioning, and not forgetting the essential ingredient to share our life together. That would make more sense if she confused the roles and identified with the self-destructive urges to base her decisions on. Maybe one of the reasons why Chris didn't feel like she was married and hadn't accepted that choice, because she had to be convinced, and it didn't seem as valid without her family being at the wedding. I mean, it seemed to me at the time of the wedding that she was pouting, and because none of her family could be there. I mean, it is possible, you know, if we went and had a ceremony in Georgia, that maybe that would be what she was missing, and want to be more committed to working things out. It could be part of a test to see how far I would go and what I would overcome. After all, in that video, I did write that there was no mountain too high and no river too wide, because I would go to any length to rescue my soulmate. And I wrote it for that video, then I said it and recorded to put in the voiceover in the video, and I definitely meant that I would fulfill that promise. So doesn't that mean that I should live up to it? That's hard to do without the other side of whether or not she would accept my doing that. But at least it showed that I would live up to my commitment, even if she couldn't. I mean, there would be the ethical thing. If it was part of the myth, like in Roswell, where Liv goes to the boarding school to get her head straight, dealing with all the drama and trauma from Max, then he has to track her down, because most overriding instinct to have her when his body was stolen still would show a lot of that kind of devotion, especially in the song, Cheryl Crow song, I Shall Believe.
And not everything is gonna be the way you think it ought to be. It seems like every time I try to make it right, it all comes down on me. Please say honestly you won't give up on me. I shall be. I shall be.